The sound of the old school pipe organ, or see this big wooden pulpit that I'm standing in, these images carry with it some fondness. It might be that when you see them, they bring a certain sense of nostalgia to you, because maybe as you think about church, this is what you think about. Or maybe it's just a reminder of something that you imagined from years and years gone by, that that's what church looked like. Or maybe it's from a movie, a timepiece that takes you way back. But you know what it does communicate to some of us, maybe many of us, is a sense of stability, a sense of longevity, a place that you can really trust because it's been around a long time. And it has that sense of fondness for us. And you know, I guess church ought to be that, shouldn't it? It should have that sense of fondness. It ought to be maybe the one place that we can find in our lives where, because it's trustworthy, that it has a sense of where I can be myself, where I don't have to pretend, I don't have to be somebody that I'm not, that I'm going to gather with my friends and they know me, they know the happenings of my life, and we love to be together and just be ourselves. It might be, maybe ought to be, the one place that I can be most myself. And so when you see these images of the old school pipe organ, or you see this wooden pulpit, or the old hard wooden chairs, or the stained glass, whatever it might be, maybe it brings back all those good feelings and a good sense of how safe and secure and how trustworthy the church ought to be. Well, that's exactly what this place is for so many people. But it's not a church. I'm here at Lis Doon Varna Irish Pub right here in our city. And every single week, sometimes several times a week, this is where people from our community come to, well, be themselves. It's a place of familiarity, it's a place of stability in one sense, and it's a place where I can be who I am. People come here because they know that even if their life isn't in order, and even if their life isn't what they wish it would be, they can come to a place and people aren't going to criticize them and complain about them. They're not going to try to fix them and correct them and judge them, but they're going to be with friends, friends who are going to encourage them, friends they can laugh with and even cry with and share their secrets with. It's a place of that kind of safety where the guard comes down and there is that sense that I can just be who I am, even if I don't like who I am. It's a place that is kind of a sanctuary, I guess, in a sea of trouble and difficulty in our world. And so people gather in places just like this to find some place where they can be accepted, they don't have to pretend, and they can let their guard down and just be themselves. You know, there's something inside of us that has a strong draw to be real and authentic, where we don't have to pretend. And we find it in a place like this, at least some people do. But you know, if there is one place that we ought to find that kind of safety and trust and a place we don't have to pretend and we can let our guard down, you know where it ought to be? It ought to be in the community of followers of Jesus Christ, in our homes, in our lives, and certainly in our gatherings as a community of faith, whether it's through the week in life groups or it's here as we are this Sunday morning. It ought to be a place of acceptance and where people don't have to pretend, where we don't have to pretend, and others don't. You know why? Because it's the very model that Jesus gave for us and asks us to do what he did himself and he did for us. Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name.